Today in the news, we got some new memory for some old cards, some new features on an old game, and new info on a classic console. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Let's get started with Nvidia. It seems like their Pascal inventory is still quite full as we get our second GPU rejuvenation. At least that is what a Zotac product page shows us. On it, we can see a new GTX 1070 model, but this time with GDDR5X. In case you didn't know, the 1060 had a similar treatment a few weeks ago, but one of the biggest differences there was that the 1060 switched from a fully fledged GP106 chip to a toned down GP104. This could mean, and I know I'm pushing it a little bit far here, but it could mean that with a little bit of a BIOS injection, you could transform your 1060 into a 1070 or better. I mean, it has been done before where a GeForce card could turn into a Quadro with a little bit of modding, so why not? Going back to the 1070 though, it is the exact same chip as it was before, a GP104. Now we still don't have any numbers on how much performance we're adding thanks to GDDR5X memory, but I don't think it would be enough for the 1070 to cross 1070 Ti performance. What do you guys think? Let me know down below. Moving on, let's talk Intel. I wanted to talk about this for a while, but I just never really had the time to cover it. Now that we're getting more and more info, I think it's time. We all know that 10 nanometer is late and yada yada yada, but Intel has also been working on its 7 nanometers at the same time. According to Intel, it is being worked on by a separate team with a largely separate effort. Now, this is probably just Intel trying to keep a straight face with the delays on 10 nanometers, but at the same time, they're probably working really hard on 7 nanometers to try and get back into the leading position that they had before. With AMD on track to 7 nanometers in 2019, that could mean that the 10 nanometer for Intel might have an extremely short life. Here are my predictions based on new information available to the public and a lot of gut feeling. I'll brand this the Snow's Roadmap for Intel. In 2019, we'll have an extra chip added to the 9th generation of CPUs. That will be the Comet Lake 10 Core SKU at 14 nanometers, possibly even 10 nanometers as a die shrink alone. It will be released alone, similar to how the 9th generation only had 3 chips in it. Shortly after, in the same year, probably the holiday period or in Q1 of 2020, we'll have a fully fledged family of 10 nanometer products under the long expected name of Cannon Lake. I expect this one to ramp up in core count thanks to AMD's fierce competition in the market. And lastly, in 2021, we'll have hopefully a redesigned 7 nanometer chip from Intel. A lot of publications are saying that 10 nanometer will be short-lived, so I just wanted to give you guys a glimpse of what I think will happen. What do you guys think will happen? Let me know down below. Alright, let's talk gaming since we haven't done that in a while. First up, the Stanley Parable. Do you guys remember that game? It's an amazing storytelling game with multiple endings that really took me by surprise. It was released back in 2013, 2011 if you count the Half-Life mod, and is honestly the best game that I never played. Yep, all I did was watch the story play out on a few GT Live livestreams. Well, it seems like it's getting an ultra deluxe upgrade in 2019. It will have more endings, more choices, more dialogue, and will be available on console for the first time. Now, I still don't intend to buy it since I prefer to let the story play out on its own rather than moving the character myself. Is that weird? Have you ever watched a like full game play out in front of you without playing the game itself? If so, let me know down below. I'd love to know what game it was. Also in gaming, it looks like the PlayStation Classic was tested with a lot more games than the ones included. This information comes from the fact that the emulator used on the console was open source, which means that they had to release their own version of the modified code on GitHub. In that code, a title.h file was found with the tested game that didn't see a release, and oh boy did they miss out on potential buyers because some of those games would have definitely made me buy one. Highlights include Crash Bandicoot 1 and 2, Tomb Raider 1 and 2, Tony Hawk Pro Skaters 1 and 2, Parappa the Rapper, and more. The reason they weren't included could also be because of poor performance though. Apparently, a lot of people are having frame rate issues in certain games because some of the ports are from PAL region's versions of the game. And since PAL is 50 FPS and we are at 60 FPS, then it needs to double some frames so it looks a little bit choppy at times. Did you buy a PS Classic? Let me know down below. Anyways, that is pretty much it for the news. Hopefully you've enjoyed. Don't forget to drop a like and a comment discussing today's topic down below. As you know, I'm always down there. You can click right here to see the latest video and right here to subscribe to the channel. As always, stay frosty and I'll see you on the next one. Hey.